हेलो एवरीबॉडी, दिस इज मनोज कुमार। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ ग्रेट चैप्टर, अ ग्रेट स्टोरी फ्रॉम द बुक ऑफ द फर्स्ट फ्लाइट। द चैप्टर नेम इज ए लेटर टू गॉड। दिस इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस बुक। ए लेटर टू गॉड इज रिटन बाय जी एल फिनिट्स। बाय हिज प्रोफेशन ही इज ए पोइट, ही इज ए जर्नलिस्ट एंड राइटर एज वेल एज ही इज ए मैक्सिकन राइटर। He has written many short stories. Among them, A Letter to God is also a short story. It is an ironical story where the starting is totally different and the end is totally different. Here, this is the story of a farmer who depends on his field. Not only he, but also his whole entire family depends on the crops. Whatever he harvests, the result he gets, the whole family sustain on that crops, the grain which he earns. So as there is only one source of harvest, that is water, he gets water from the rain. One day, what happened? He was expecting a rain, and suddenly what happened? The rain falls for a few moment, but after a while it has been transformed into a hailstorm. Now here, hailstorm is a ice storm, a shower of ice storm. It feels or it seems like a pulse in a round shape, a white color. It is very beautiful for the children, but as he is farmer, he know the consequences of this. The hailstorm remain in this valley where he lives for the whole night. In the morning when he found that the whole valley, whole greenery has been covered into a white salt. Under the white salt curtain. Now here, his hope, his hard work, not only but also his whole family hard work, as all the family were involved in this profession, in the farming. Now what they have, the other option? They have nothing. There is no any source of income for them. So what will happen now? What should they do? They should ask for help? No. As their house is on the crest of a hill, there is a mountain where he established his house on the top, and neighboring, there is no any neighbor, there is no relative. So how he could get help? Who can assist him? No one can assist him except God. As he has extreme faith in God, which we don't have. He thinks that the God only can help him. The God can take him out from this problem. Now, what will happen? He thinks that if he writes a letter to God, definitely God will help him. Is it true? It can be happened? We are not sure, but something will happen. We will come to know in this chapter. In the end, the ending was so surprised, so funny, so amazing. So here, as I have already mentioned that this chapter is about the faith. Now let's talk about faith. We have faith. We have faith in our family, friends, God, everybody. Big circle where we do faith. Now, I'll explain one by one line, and it will be very helpful for you. At the end, I'll give you a quiz and 3-4 questions, main important questions. I'll mention which is up definitely you could find in your exam. The important questions, and also you will be able to get the answer. And whatever the questions are there, you will reply me through the comment, through any source of more. Now here, let's have the beginning. In this first paragraph, you could see that this chapter here, you could see in this paragraph, In this paragraph, you could see that is all about the faith and the introduction of Lencho. Here, as I have told you, that Lencho by profession is a farmer and who write a letter to God. Why he writes a good letter to God? Because his fields, his crops are totally hewn. Now asking for the help of the God. Now, here he is asking for the 100 pesos. You could see in this line that he is asking for the 100 pesos. And now, he is saying that please God help him and send him some money. He asking for the 100 pesos. So now, read the meaning and get some knowledge about this chapter. Now here, these are the activities where you can see that the way of writing a letter, the way of sending a telegram, money order, that the pay rupees, you can see that this is a form of a writing a telegram. Now here, in this today world, as we know, as the many of the students, we don't know what is telegram, what is this form of mode of payment, what it is used. It is a use for the having money from the other source. But today we have many online options. We are in the world of digital media, so there is many things. Now here, read the chapter. Now here we have in the blue color, we have a word meaning that is crest. Crest is a top of a hill. Now here, the house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. From the height, one could see the river and the fields of the ripe corn dotted with the flower that always promised a good harvest. Now here you could see, my dear students, now here how beautifully the house is situated on the natural land. This is a valley, a mountaining area where many fields are there, his own his fields, as well as his house is situated at the peak of the mountain. And from this mountain, from the house, he could see downside a great view. What is there? There is a river, fields of ripe corn dotted with the flowers, always promised a good harvest. Now here, when he see downside, there is a river as well as his own ripe corn dotted fields. What is corn? Corn is makka. He is having a harvest of corn. And this harvest, whenever anybody see a look that harvest, look at that field, it looks that the field is totally ripe. The crops is ripe. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour. Downpour means heavy rain, or at least a shower. Now he is asking, or he is expecting a little bit downpour is there, or a little bit shower is there. Then the little bit like whatever the requirement is there to become a proper crop or a ripe crop, then he can have a very nice crop or nice grain. So this was his requirement. Throughout the morning, Lencho, who knew the field intimately means know clearly, he know that his field requirement what, the crop requirement what, had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. He didn't have any option except waiting for the rain or looking at the sky. Now, we really going to get some water. The woman who was preparing supper is a food. Now here he is asking, here he is saying to his wife that today we might get rain. There is a very unique chances of rain. And what was the reply of the woman or the wife of this farmer who was preparing supper? Replied, yes, God willing, by the grace of God, we can have. The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house until the woman called to them all, come for dinner. Now here, this is the family background of this person, the farmer whose name is Lencho. He, as well as his whole children who were called out by his wife who was preparing food, and when the food was prepared, the mother called his all children. It was during the meal that just as Lancho had predicted, as he was having this idea, as he's having this mindset that today it might be rain, what happened? Big drops of rain began to fall. Now, as he was expecting, as he was having little bit surety, and the same thing happened. There was a rain. Rain started falling. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. From the east side, northeast side, he was looking, and what he's saying, he see that many big clouds, black clouds, were approaching towards his valley, towards his fields, towards his house, as it was a good sign of rain. The air was fresh and sweet. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. Now, as I could tell you, I could bring your attention in the condition of a farmer. As those farmers who didn't have any source of water except rain, this is a very important for them. Rain is very important for them, not for them, but also for whole his profession. As his profession is farming, so he deliberately he left his food and came out from his house and wanting the feeling of the fresh air as well as the drop of rain putting on his body. As he was very charming, as he was feeling so happy, the man went out for the no other reason than to have a pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And when he returned, he exclaimed, "These are not raindrops falling from the sky. They are a new coins. The big drops are 10 cents pieces and the little ones are 5. As he is telling his whole family that these drops are not only a drops, these are the pennies, these are the coins in a form of money. As the big drops are 10 cent or 10 pesos and the smaller one are 5 pesos. As much as the drops fall from the sky to his field, to his ground, as much as he is having a good source of income." So these words, a big drops are 10 cent, you can have in your mind, students, that these big drops means here he, whenever he is getting the grain, he the good grain, the quality of grain comes in a nice way when there is a little bit shower, as he already mentioned in this earlier paragraph. So now next paragraph is, what a satisfied expression. He regarded the field of ripe corn with its flower. Here regarded means he want to thanks, he wants to gratitude to his ripe corn. And he was very happy, he was so excited to see that the lush green greenery and the water, the drops are on the each and every piece of leaf with covered with water. Draped in a curtain of rain. Now here, the whole fields are under the water, under the drop of rain. But suddenly, a strong wind began to blow. And along with the rain, very large hailstorms began to fall. These truly did resemble new silver coins. The boys, exposing themselves to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Now here, mentioning this, what is the meaning of frozen pearls? I'll explain. Now here, as earlier there was a rain, there was a very nice rain was happening, but suddenly the rain has been transformed into a hail stones. Large hailstones. As I have told you, what is the meaning of hailstones? Big stone, ice stone, started falling from the sky. And it truly resembled with the coins. The drop of water was not resembling with the coin, but here the stone, it is a form of ice, it totally resemble, totally intimate with the coins. As here coins means pearls, you have seen a different type of pearls, green, white, black, blue. Here the white pearls, here under this before this there is a word frozen, that here this frozen means here they are talking about the stones, stone of ice. Now here the children's who was inside the house, when there is a drop, the smaller children, not bigger children, the smaller children were came out and look at that. This is a very nice, a nice movement for them to see that frozen ice. "It is really getting bad now," exclaimed the man. The Lancho was very hurt. He was in a sad, it was a panic moment for him, because this hailstones definitely can destroy his whole crops. Now what he say added, sorry, "I hope it passes quickly." It didn't pass quickly for an hour. Then the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, on the whole valley. The field was white as if covered with salt. Now here. Now the hailstone remains continuously for hours, and it was not passed quickly. It remained on this valley. And what happened after a while? After an hour, what he observed, he see that the whole house, the whole garden, the whole hillside, the even the cornfield on the whole valley was totally white. Earlier it was green, but now the whole valley was looking white. And it looks like that somebody has put too much salt on the valley, spread salt everybody, but it was not salt, it was the ice. Note.